गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल इन योर स्टडी। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन टू, दैट इज सेंस एंड सेंसिटिविटी। आई होप यू ऑल हैव स्टडीड इन योर अर्लियर क्लासेज अबाउट सेंसेज। सो कैन यू टेल मी चिल्ड्रेन, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सेंस? ओके, आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू। सेंस मीन्स द एबिलिटी टू थिंक और एक्ट इन अ रीजनेबल और सेंसिबल वे फॉर अ गुड जजमेंट। And the meaning of sensitivity is the quality of being sensitive, such as the capacity of an organism or sense organ to respond to stimulation. Children, open page number 15. Here are some pictures. Write the names of the sense organs that enable you to perceive the following. Children, as you already know that eyes help us to see, ears help us to hear, nose helps us to smell, tongue helps us to taste, and skin helps us to touch or feel. So you can write easily these sense organs. Now let's focus on the contents that we are going to cover in this chapter. Sense organs are likes and dislikes, the differently abled, Helen Keller, Braille, and the last one, home assignments. So first topic is sense organs. Children, what are sense organs? Sense organs are the specialized organs composed of sensory neurons which help us to perceive and respond to our surroundings. There are five sense organs: eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin, that you already know that. We see, hear, smell, taste, and feel by these sense organs, but still our likes and dislikes are different. That I will explain in the next slide. So here you can see a picture, that is, eyes help us to sight, nose helps us to smell, tongue and mouth helps us to taste, ears help us to hear, and skin helps us to touch. Now next topic is our likes and dislikes. Children, our five senses help us to discover the world around us and communicate with each other. Our sense organs perform the same functions, but the brain interprets them differently. We see, hear, feel, taste, and smell, but still our likes and dislikes are different from one another. Can you tell me why? What makes our likes and dislikes different from one another? Okay, I will tell you. This is done according to the family values, traditions, regional and environmental influences. Open page number 16. Children, here are some stories. You will get clue by these stories why our likes and dislikes are different. John is excited when the bell rings for the sports period. His father runs a gymnasium and always encourages his children to take part in physical activities and keep fit. What is the meaning of gymnasium? A large room used for various indoor sports such as basketball or boxing. Children, you will get these stories on page number 16. So read page number 16 very carefully. So hence John loves games and sports. Next story, Savvy's parents tell her not to waste time in music and sports and instead concentrate on studies. Savvy's father is a scientist and is always busy with his experiments. Hence, Savvy has developed a scientific aptitude. What is the meaning of aptitude? The meaning of aptitude is natural ability or skill, talent. These children have different likes and dislikes because of their family backgrounds. Okay, next, Rohan and Ali stop by a restaurant. Rohan, being a Hindu Brahman, is a vegetarian. He goes for dosa. Ali belongs to a Muslim family. He is a non-vegetarian and eats chicken curry. The two boys make different food choices because they have different tastes on account of the habits they have cultivated from their families. Next story, Jeba lives in Kashmir where it is very cold and Vijayalakshmi lives in Chennai where the climate is humid. What is the meaning of humid? Containing a lot of water and warm. They visit Nainital during the winter vacation. Ziva is comfortable here because she loves cold climate and she used for it. Vijayalakshmi shivers and cannot tolerate and cold for she is not habituated to such a climate. The two girls adapt themselves to the climate in Nainital differently because of their different geographical background. So this is how we develop our likes and dislikes and a particular way of life because of our culture, traditions, family values, regional and environmental influences. Next topic is differently abled. But before going to explain that topic, I want to tell you a story. Here is a story of the elephant and the blind man. Children, you can see here are six blind men. Now I am going to explain this story. Six blind men come across an elephant. They have no idea what an elephant is. Each one of them touches the elephant and gives his perception. What is the meaning of perception? Perception means the ability to notice or understand something. Hey, the elephant is like a pillar, says the first man who touches its leg. Oh no, it is like a rope, says the second man who touches the tail. Oh no, it is like a thick branch of a tree, says the third man who touches the trunk of the elephant. It is like a big hand fan, says the fourth man who touches the ear of the elephant. It is like a huge wall, says the fifth man who touches the belly of the elephant. No, it is like a solid pipe, says the sixth man who touches the tusk of the elephant. Children, you can see, though all are wrong in a way, but each blind man is partially right. This story shows that every person has a different perspective of viewing something. So our next topic is the differently abled. We are dependent on our sense to perceive our environment. However, we realize their importance only when one or more of the senses fail to work. Children, I am going to explain more about the differently abled, so listen very carefully. People with disabilities do not want to be PTA'd or be differently behaved with. They just want to live a normal life. The blind have to be guided, the mentally challenged need to be assisted, and the physically challenged need help to get things done for him or her. We have to play our part in helping them survive in this world with dignity and ease. A friendly handshake or a warm smile can do a lot and build up confidence in a person. We should not pity them or feel sorry for them. This would make them feel inferior. We can just ask for help if they need any. For every human being, dignity and respect are the foremost things. No one desires to be looked down upon or pitied by others. Here I am going to tell you about Helen Keller. Helen Keller, she could not see, hear or talk. However, she studied and spent her life helping others. She went on to earn a bachelor's degree in spite of being a hearing and visually impaired person. Here I am going to tell you more about Helen Keller. Helen Keller's teacher taught Helen to read Braille. One day she took Helen's hand and dipped it in water and spelled the word water, W-A-T-E-R, on her palm. From then on, Helen learned to read and write. She also taught her to speak. Helen had lost the ability to speak because she had not heard sound for a long time. She touched her teacher's face and mouth when her teacher spoke, and then she would touch her own face and mouth to say the same word. It was a slow and difficult process, but finally Helen began to speak. She relied on her sense of touch instead of her sense of sight. Helen Keller used Braille, I will tell you about Braille in the next slide. She used Braille to read in order to recognize the alphabet. She had to rely on her sense of touch. Next topic is Braille. Braille is a special script written on a thick paper with 1 to 6 raised dots. I'm going to tell you more about Braille. Braille was invented by a French educator, Louis Braille, who himself was blind. This system helps the blind to read and study different subjects and helps them achieve success in school. Braille is now accepted as the only form of written communication for the blind all over the world. Braille is a writing system that helps people read by feeling with their hands, as you can see in these pictures also. It has 6 raised dots made in different combinations on paper that represent letters, punctuation marks, and symbols also. The hands recognize what the sequences of dots represent, and by connecting the dots, words and sentences are formed. Braille is read by moving the hands from left to right along each line, usually by using the first finger of both hands. Each set of raised dot, it stands for a letter and alphabets. One needs to roll fingers on these dots to read the letters and words. Children, we come across many courageous people with various impairments who refuse to burden the society with their disability. This I am going to tell you in the next slide. Children, here you can see some pictures that they are disabled person, but they did not lose their hope. They made the country proud. The first picture you can see. She is Deepa Malik. She is the first Indian woman to win a Paralympic medal. She is confident India's medal tally at the Tokyo Paralympic next year will be in the double digits. The 49-year-old from Bheswal, Haryana, created history during the Rio Paralympic Games in 2016, clinching the silver medal in the F53 short put event. The next picture is Sudha Chandran. Sudha Chandran met with a terrible accident one time that resulted in the amputation of her right leg. Despite the crushing disability, Sudha Chandran emerged as one of the most acclaimed and influential classical dancers in India. Next picture is Arunima Sinha. You have already heard about Arunima Sinha. Children, she was pushed from a running train by some robbers in 2011 while she was resisting them. As a result, her left leg had to be amputated below the knee. She got rots in the right leg and multiple fractures in the spinal cord. Her aim was to climb each of the continent's highest peaks and hoist the national flag of India. She has already done 7 peaks till 2014, Everest in Asia, Kilimanjaro in Africa, Elbrus in Europe, Kosciuszko in Australia, Aconcagua in Argentina, and Karstens Pyramid in Indonesia. She completed her final summit of Mount Vinson in Antarctica on 1 January 2019. In 2015, the Government of India honored her with the Padma Shri Award, the 4th highest civilian award of India. Next picture is Varun Singh Bhati. He is a para high jumper from India. He was afflicted by poliomyelitis at a young age and joined sports during his school days. He has won several medals in international events, including bronze at 2016 Summer Paralympic Games and 2017 World Para Athletes Championships. Ravindra Jain. who overcome lifelong blindness to achieve renown in his native India and beyond as a singer and composer, scoring more than 200 Bollywood films. So children, we should be sensitive towards differently abled people. Public buildings, offices, hospitals, and even schools should be constructed keeping in mind their needs and safety. Wheelchair ramps, wide doorways and halfways and lifts should be made to make it easy for them to move around. So this is the time for some homework. I think you all have understood this chapter. If you have any problem, you can ask. Just go through the video, read the chapter very, very carefully and ask your query there. Read the chapter thoroughly and underline the difficult words. Learn the difficult words. To understand the Braille alphabet and letters, take A4 size paper and engraved on it for alphabets and letters as shown in the slide number 10. Draw the sense organs and color it in front of difficult words. Learn word wagon. Learn everything from book and notebook. So, stay home, stay safety. Thank you to all children.